he was more at one with himself, more relaxed, more happy. And I don't think he ever thought that I would be supportive of him, of him becoming a gay. But I was, because it was part of himself. And it was nice to see Freddie at one with himself. It was more than nice, it was wonderful. It was such a happy person that you couldn't deny Freddie the right to be at one with himself. I see it as a love that that you accept and somehow understand, because you want the person inside to grow, and you're fascinated to see this person within totally at ease and at one with themselves. There's a great feeling, a great almost euphoric feeling that you are witnessing, that the development is just... And he gave so much, so how could you not give?
Freddie had, you know, great taste, and you know, the sort of surroundings of his beautiful home sometimes led to a really rather sort of relaxed, sophisticated evening. But other times, yeah, there was a you know, the odd wild moment, which I would, I think, need to consult my lawyer before talking about in great detail.
Freddie knew how to give a party.
Freddie threw many of the wildest parties in the history of rock. This footage was shot at one of the greatest of all, his 39th birthday in Munich.
You walk in, and there were trolls and dwarves and ogres and thieves and ballerinas and transvestites and transsexuals, and I think there's two or three people of the third sex there.
Are we X-rated? Let's get everybody
jumping. He did have the most extraordinary parties. And get
everybody stomping. There was a dwarf covered in liver, and he laid there on a platter like this, and whenever anybody dug this dull knife into him, he would go like that. And the whole plate of liver would quiver, or like pate kind of thing. So it was like a moving pate pastiche. Let's turn it on,
yeah. Nobody's giving it up, yeah. I had no intention of going in a pool with anybody.
I wound up in flagrante delicto under the catering table. It was pretty much wretched excess. That was the worst thing I've ever been to. I'll probably go to hell because of that.
It's nice memories though. Turn it on, get right into that lovely
feeling. Let's turn it on, yeah. My 3-4 days became the longest party. I stayed for 3 weeks.
It scared a lot of people, especially the locals. We could take it. You know, I'm used to seeing my grandmother crawl up my leg with a knife in her teeth.
I remember driving around in his car, in his Rolls Royce sometimes in London, if we were very jolly, and I'd put my head out the window and start singing. I could have danced all night at the top of my voice, and he on the other side, and frightening people.
Freddie tended to do things in the grand style. I mean, like flying 80 people off to Barcelona for a party or whatever. I mean, I don't see him as a Volvo estate man, primarily, no.
And he spent his money, what he got, for himself, but not on the first thing, for others. Let him have fun. Because I only have fun if I can give and see that, so that I can make other people happy, whatever it is.
Out comes the Ribena, and it begins. Or you run, or you think, oh, no, I can't, I've got to go.
It's flamenco dancers, fireworks. It was extraordinary. It was like being on a Fellini set.
It was one of those parties where you had to come dressed as your favourite person. And he just came dressed as himself, obviously.
I'm Jim Houghton. Freddie's last lover. You take my
body. Freddie's sexuality, never a straightforward matter, was shaped by the experimental, liberal attitudes of the late 60s and 70s.
The bisexual thing, the androgynous, the boy-girl, the he-she, the ambiguity, that was the spirit of the time. And Freddie was right in the middle of that, spiritually, emotionally, sexually. And he was clearly a man of his time.
I think part of it was the sort of fashion of the day, but part of it was very much him. He was always kind of a bit larger than anybody else and would go a little bit more to extremes than anyone else.
That appealed to me. I liked that. David Bowie was my friend, and so he, Freddie was like one step beyond David in terms of how camp he was. I suck your mind, you blow my head.
Make love inside your bed, everybody get down, make love. Get down, make love. Get down, make love.
As far as Freddie was concerned, his sexuality was his own business.
There was a lot of things Freddie like kept to himself, and that you know, I suppose it was one of them, really. I don't think he really ever discussed it with anyone other than probably Mary.
He felt that was one side of him that he didn't want anyone to know about.
Freddie didn't have to shout or demonstrate. He lived gay. If you went anywhere near him or were involved with him, he was gay. I can squeeze, you can shake me. I can feel when you break me. He had his boyfriends, and he didn't hide it, but on the other hand, he didn't show off about it.
He liked to keep the mystique about him. Signs are there for anyone to see, but then again, what are signs, you know? It's, I could see somebody mincing down the street there and say, oh, he's gay, not necessarily so.
I think he's somebody who just lived his life how he wanted, very much, and really didn't want to become a figurehead for the gay movement particularly. Get down,
get down. There were, I think, at least two occasions in the press where he admitted to being gay. But they don't really, I mean, it's there in black and white, but people don't pick on it. They haven't picked up on it.
You don't acquiesce or deny, or I think you just... Come into my life, to my
life. It's a man-made paradise. He was a youngster today, a young 30-year-old, 40-year-old. It wouldn't bother him. You know, because things have changed so much over the years. Which I suppose in a way he did, yeah, played his part.
I'm not scared of doing what I want to do. Before I'd sort of hide in my past, like when I went out, I had to sort of try and perform a little as well and say, like, not letting them down and the thing like, because Freddie Mercury, I don't know what it means, but he had to react in a certain way, what the press had told people.